perquisites. So we have discussed the definition first of perquisites under Section 17, Clause 2. Then, now, how you will be valuing the perquisites? Because if a house has been provided, now how you have to value the house facility for the purpose of charging tax on the same? For that purpose, we have been provided, say, separate rules. That is Rule 3 of the Income Tax Rules, 1962, provides for the valuations of these perquisites. The first one is the rent-free accommodation. Now here, we will be valuing what? The rent-free accommodation. That is rent-free accommodation. That is house facility. If the employer has provided to the employee the house, how you will be valuing the same, because the taxable value of that perquisite will be chargeable. So fundamentally, how you will be valuing the same, for that we have got valuation rules. Now here, we have to see whether the accommodation is provided by the government employer or say it is any other employer. Here we have to see employer. If it's a government employer, he has provided the accommodation to its employees. The accommodation to the employees. Then, in case of the non-government employers, if they have provided accommodation to the employees, how you will be valuing the same? In case if the government has provided the accommodation to the employer, to its employees, then what will, be the taxable value of perquisite? Here we have to determine what? The taxable value. So taxable value is equal to what? The license fees. License fees determined by the government in respect of such accommodation. In respect of such accommodation. It is the license fees which has been determined by the government in respect of such accommodation. The same will be the taxable value of the perquisite. It will be what? The taxable value of the perquisite. It is the license fees which is determined by the government in respect of this accommodation. The same is the taxable value of perquisite. So if the license fees is, say, determined by the government 500 rupees per month. If it is 500 per month and the market rent is, say, 15,000 per month. Market rent of that accommodation is 15,000 per month. But the license fees is 500 rupees per month. So here the taxable value is equal to 500 per month. That will be the taxable value of the perquisite. For 12 months, it is, 6,000 rupees. The same will be the taxable value of the perquisite. Whereas in case of the non-government employees, we have to see, what we have to see? We have to see the whether the accommodation is, say, owned by the employer. Accommodation is owned by the employer. Or accommodation is taken on rent or lease by the employer. If the same is taken on rent or lease by the employer, and then provided to employee. So if the accommodation is owned by the employer, then we have to see the in which cities the accommodation is provided. Cities having population. Cities having population not exceeding 10 lakhs or say exceeding 10 lakhs but not exceeding 25 lakhs or we are having exceeding 25 lakhs. So in case if it is not exceeding 10 lakhs, then 7.5% of salary, 7.5% of salary is a taxable value of perquisite. If it exceeds 10 lakh, but it does not exceed 25 lakhs, it will be 10% of the salary will be the taxable value of perquisite. And if it exceeds 25 lakhs, it is 15% of the salary that will be the taxable value of perquisite. So this is the taxable value. It is either 7.5% of salary or 10% of salary or 15% of salary. In case the population does not exceed 10 lakhs, if it exceeds 10 lakhs but does not exceed 25 lakhs, or if it exceeds 25 lakhs, then it is 15% of salary. And in case if the accommodation is taken on lease and then provided to the employees, then you know what will be the taxable value of perquisite? It is a lease rent paid. Or 15% of salary, whichever is less. It is a lease rent paid or 15% of salary, whichever is less. And here, if the accommodation is furnished accommodation, if the accommodation is furnished accommodation, then here we'll be determining the value as if the accommodation is unfurnished. As if the accommodation is unfurnished, and in that what will be added? In that what will be added? If furniture is what? Owned by the employer. If furniture is owned by the employer, then 10% per annum of the original cost of furniture. Of the original cost of furniture is added. If furniture is taken on rent and then provided to the employee, then the lease rent paid in respect of such furniture, the same shall be added to determine the taxable value of perquisite. Then, if it is an accommodation which has been provided at concessional rate, accommodation provided at concessional rate, if the accommodation is provided at concessional rate, then what will be the taxable value of perquisite? Taxable value will be equal to what? Value of rent-free accommodation and from that we'll reduce what? The rent recovered from employee. Rent recovered from employee. The same will be reduced to arrive at what? The taxable value of the perquisite. So here the value of residential accommodation, the value of residential accommodation, we are determining that. And here basically what accommodation means. Here accommodation has been defined in an inclusive manner. It is not just a house only or a flat only. It includes a house, it includes flat, it may include a farmhouse or a part thereof, or accommodation may be provided in a hotel, or it may be provided in a motel, or it may be provided in a service apartment, it may be provided in a guest house or carva or mobile home, ship or any other floating structure. So here accommodation, that is includes a house, flat, farmhouse, accommodation in a hotel, motel, service apartment, guest house, carva, mobile home, ship or other floating structure. Now how you will be valuing the same? So in case the value of the residential accommodation which is provided by the employer directly or indirectly to the assessee or to any member of his household. Now here the member of household has also been given. What a member of household means here, the member of household has been defined and it is what? It will be including their spouse, it will be including their children and their spouses, parents and servants and dependents. They are coming under the ambit of what? The members of household. The members of household will include spouse, children and their spouses, parents, servants and dependents. So they are coming under the ambit of the members of household. Now if this accommodation has been provided to the assessee or any member of the household by reason of his employment, the value will be determined as under. We have discussed the same. Where the accommodation has been provided by the government, if the accommodation has been provided by the government to the employees holding office or post in connection with the government affairs, the value of the accommodation, in case it is unfurnished accommodation, if the accommodation is say unfurnished, it is a license fees which is determined by the government, whatever the license fee determined by the government, as reduced by the rent actually paid or paid by the employee. It is a license fees which has been determined by the government, reduced by the rent which is actually paid by the employee. And in case if the accommodation is furnished, then first of all the value is determined as if the accommodation is unfurnished, and in that what will be added? 10% per annum of the cost of furniture if owned by the employer, or actual hire charges payable in case of furniture is taken on hire. So 10% per annum of the original cost. Say if a refrigerator has been provided, say a fridge has been provided whose cost is say 50,000 rupees is the original cost, and the same has been provided on 1st of October 20XX by the employer to the employee. So it will be 50,000 into 10% per annum. For 6 months it has been taken now from 1st of October 20XX to 31st of March 20XY. So it will be how much? Say it is 5,000 for half year, 2500 rupees will be added. And in case if any amount is recovered from the employee, the same is, say, reduced to arrive at what the taxable value of perquisite. Then the second one is what? Where the accommodation is provided by any other employer and such accommodation is owned by the employer. Accommodation is, say, owned by the employer. Then what will be the taxable value? In cities having population exceeding 25 lakhs, as per the last preceding census, it is 15% of salary. Exceeds 10 lakhs but does not exceed 25 lakhs, it is 10% of salary. And in case the city's population does not exceed 10 lakhs, then it is what? 7.5% of salary. That is a taxable value. So we have to determine what salary here means. The salary means what? Basic salary plus DNS allowance if it forms part of retirement benefits, plus percentage wise fixed commission on turnover, that is percentage wise fixed commission on turnover, plus all taxable allowances, taxable portion of allowances that will be added, plus all the monetary payments, whatever all other monetary payments have been received, the same will be added, plus all monetary payments. What will not be included is DA, to the extent it do not form part of the retirement benefits. Exempt allowances will not be included. Perquisites will not be included. Retirement benefits will not be included. Retirement benefits, the same will not be what? Included here. So that is salary, and you have to determine the same. It is 7.5% of salary. In case the population does not exceed 10 lakhs, it is 10% of salary. If population exceeds 10 lakhs but does not exceed 25 lakhs, or it is what, 15% of salary if the population exceeds 25 lakhs. But in case if the accommodation is taken on lease by the employer and then provided to the employee, it is a lease rent paid or 15% of salary, whichever is, say, lower, that will be the taxable value. In case if any amount is recovered from the employee, it is reduced. In case furniture is also provided, the concept remains same. If the furniture is owned by the employer, 10% per annum of the original cost of furniture will be added. If furniture is taken on rent and then provided to the employee, the lease rent paid by the employer will be added. Whatever amount is recovered from the employee, the same is what? Reduced. Then in case if the accommodation is provided in a hotel, so in a hotel, since hotel accommodation is furnished accommodation, they say that lease rent paid or 24% of salary whichever is lower. Where the accommodation is provided by the above employer in a hotel, then here the actual charges paid or payable to such hotel or 24% of salary which are less. And in case any amount is, say, recovered from the employee, if any amount is recovered from the employee, it will be what? Reduced to arrive at the taxable value of the perquisite. Any amount which is recovered from the employee, the same is reduced to arrive at the taxable value. Now we are saying that is a 10% of salary or 15% of salary or, say, 24% of salary or 7.5% of salary. What salary means here? Though we have discussed it. Here basically salary means basic salary plus DNS allowance your pay if it forms a part of superannuation or retirement benefits. Bonuses included. Commission, fees, all taxable allowances, all monetary payments chargeable to tax, from one or more employers. So here it is basic salary, DNS allowance to the extent it forms part of retirement benefit, the same is included, bonus, commission, fees, all taxable allowances, all monetary payments which are chargeable to tax one or more employers. And what salary does not include? Here salary does not include what? The DNS allowance or DNS pay. To the extent it do not form the part of retirement benefits. So if you are receiving DA 25,000 rupees per month, if you are receiving DA 25,000 rupees per month, 40% of which forms the part of retirement benefit, so 10,000 rupees will be included, but 15,000 will not be included. Then employer's contribution to the provident fund account of the employee, that will not be included. Allowances which are exempt from payment of tax. So if you are receiving a children educational allowance of 200 rupees per month for one child, 100 rupees is exempt, then 100 rupees portion which is exempt from tax, the same will not be included. The allowances which are exempted from payment of tax, then the value of perquisites, no perquisite will be included, whether it's monetary payment or non-monetary payment. Perquisite will not be, say, included. Then any payment or expenditure specifically excluded under section 17.2.3 proviso or proviso to section 17.2. So that will not be included. And lump sum payments which are received at a time of retirement or termination of service or on superannuation like gratuity, severance pay, leave encashment, VRS, commutation of pension and similar payments. They will not be what? Included here. So fundamentally, salary does not include the following. Then comes the, you know, exemption has been provided. Exemption has been provided in respect of housing accommodation. Accommodation is provided in a hotel. If accommodation is provided in a hotel and for a period not exceeding 15 days, and the same has been provided on account of transfer, not exceeding 15 days in aggregate in previous year, in that case, the same will be what? Exempt. So when the employee is provided accommodation or hotel for a period not exceeding 15 days on account of his transfer from one place to another, then the value of perquisite shall be taken as nil. In such a case, the value of perquisite, the same shall be taken as nil. When the accommodation is provided in a hotel for a period not exceeding 15 days in aggregate on account of such transfer. Then, if the accommodation is, say, provided of working sites are there, it may be a mining site, it may be an onshore oil exploration site, it may be project execution site, it may be dam site, or it may be power generation site. So if accommodation has been provided there, and these are what temporary sites, temporary natures, and accommodation basically of temporary nature it is, and the accommodations area, it must not exceed 800 square feet plinth area, and it must be located at least 8 kilometers away from the local limits of the municipality or the cantonment board. In that particular circumstance, the perquisite value shall be taken as nil. Or it is located in a remote area. Remote area is that area, it is located from a village or town having population not exceeding 20,000 as per the last preceding census, and the same is 40 kilometers away from that village. So that is basically a remote area. If accommodation is provided in a remote area, then it will be exempt. So here, exemption is also in respect of accommodation which is provided to the employee working at a mining site, onshore oil exploration site, or say offshore site, project site, dam site, power generation site. So accommodation, the same is provided to the employee working at a mining site, onshore oil exploration site, project execution site, dam site, power generation site, or offshore site, which is of temporary nature, and having the plinth area not exceeding 800 square feet, and is located not less than 8 kilometers away from the local limits of a municipality or say cantonment board, and the same is located not less than say 8 kilometers away from the local limits of municipality or a cantonment board, or the accommodation is located in a remote area. And basically what remote area means, an area that is located at least 40 kilometers away from the town, having a population not exceeding 20,000 based on last preceding census. Then in case if two accommodations are provided on account of transfer, say Mr. X is employee of XYZ Limited, he was provided accommodation in say Ajmer, Rajasthan. Then he was transferred to Mumbai. Then he has been provided accommodation in Rajasthan as well as in Mumbai. So for a period of 90 days, accommodation of lower value will be taxable. And subsequently, both the accommodations will be taxable. Where on account of say transfer from one place to another, the employee is provided with accommodation at new place of posting while retaining the accommodation at the other place, the value of perquisite will be determined as follows. That is, for a period of 90 days, the accommodation whose value is lower, the same will be taxable. And afterwards, the perquisite value, that is for both the accommodations, will be what? Chargeable to tax. In case if the government employee has been sent on deputation, if the government employee has been sent on deputation, in that case, the rules applicable to that organization will be applicable for that employee. Same will be applicable for that employee. So here, where the accommodation is provided by the central government or the state government to an employee who is serving on deputation with any body or undertaking which is under the control of the government, then the employer of such employee shall be deemed to be that body or undertaking where the employee is serving on deputation. And the value of perquisite of such accommodation shall be the amount calculated as if the accommodation is, say, owned by the employer. Value of perquisite will be what? The amount of the, that is what the accommodation, if that accommodation say owned by the employer, that rules will be applicable. So 7.5% or 10% or 15% of the salary, here the same will be applicable. So that was about the rent free accommodation. What basic thing is you have to remember is, here if the accommodation is provided by the government employer to his employees, then it is a license fee determined by the government in respect of such accommodation. In case of non-government accommodation, non-government employees, if the accommodation is owned by the employer, it is cities having population not exceeding 10 lakhs, it is 7.5% of salary. Exceeding 10 lakhs but not exceeding 25 lakhs, it is 10% of salary. Exceeding 25 lakhs, it is 15% of salary. And if the accommodation is taken on lease and then provided to the employee, lease rent paid or 15% of salary, which is say lower. And in case of hotel accommodation, lease rent paid or 24% of salary, whichever is lower, will be the taxable value of perquisite. So this was about the valuation in respect of the accommodation. Now we'll be discussing certain practical questions in relation to the same.